Hi friends, welcome to Sidhu's Biology. Today our topic is about probiotics. Let me clear one thing that these probiotics are derived from the Latin word means pro, which means before or the forward. Bios means life. Completely the probiotic is meant for life promoting agents. These probiotics are known as life promoting agents. Actually, these probiotics are the live microorganisms, means either bacteria or yeast. Bacteria, especially lactobacilli and the bifidobacter, are the main bacteria which are playing a major role as a probiotics, and yeast also playing a major role as a probiotics. These are used for good for our health. We have to be healthy, then we have to consume this probiotic rich foods, or either as a pills, either as a powder form. Especially these probiotics are useful for our digestive system to function properly. These probiotics also known as good or helpful bacteria. Because why these are called as good or helpful bacteria means they are keeping our body in the healthy state without causing any infection or disease to our body. Let's go. Actually our body is completely filled with the bacteria. Either they are good or bad. Good bacteria are commonly known as a normal flora, and the bad bacteria are known as a pathogenic bacteria, which are going to produce any infection or disease to our body. The good bacteria are known as the pink spots are known as a good bacteria, and the blue spots are known as a bad bacteria. These bad bacteria are going to produce an infection in our body, and the good bacteria are known as a probiotics. These good bacteria are inhibiting the infection or inhibiting the place of the pathogenic bacteria in our body. Coming to the history of the probiotics. These probiotics are discovered by the Eli Metchnikoff scientist. The term probiotic was given by the scientist Lilly and the Stilwell in the year 1965. This is about the history of the probiotics. Next, let me clear you that who need the probiotics means the people who are in the need to take these probiotics means the people who are suffering from the yeast infections like athlete's foot, jack itch, vaginal yeast infections, nail fungal infections. All the people who are suffering with these fungal or yeast infections, those are in the high need to take the probiotics. And the people who are having the weak immune system, those are also more prone to take those probiotics. And the people who are suffering with respiratory tract infections means breathing problem, asthma, pneumonia, like those infections those are also more prone to take those probiotics. And the people who are suffering with the food allergies or the respiratory allergies are also prone to take those probiotics. And next, coming to the inflammatory bowel disorder patients are also susceptible to take those probiotics. And next, coming to the constipation, the people who are suffering with the constipation, and also the people who are suffering with the intestinal infections are also more apt to take those probiotics. And next, coming to the what is the mode of action of these probiotics? When the people suffering with these infections, they take the probiotics, right? When they intake those probiotics, what is the role played by them in the body means production of the inhibitory compounds means if any pathogenic microorganism is entered into our body, it is promoting those proteins and promoting the infection in our body. These probiotics produce the inhibitory compounds. These inhibitory compounds act on those pathogenic microorganisms and inhibit the infection which is producing in our body. That is a role played, but that is a main role played by these probiotics. Next, coming to the enhancement of the immune system. Now, I already said that the probiotics are also used by the people who are having the weak immune system. If that people take these probiotics, then the immune system will enhance. Next, coming to the these probiotics are also acts as a source of macro and the micronutrients. We already know that macro means large, micro means small. These are playing a major role as a macro and micronutrients. Next, during the digestion process, these probiotics are acting as an enzymes to digest the food, to break down, to metabolize the food. And next, these probiotics are also used to produce low weight antibacterial substances. Antibacteria, in the name itself, we are going to know that antibacteria again is the bacteria. The substances which are going to fight against the bacteria, those are known as the antibacterial substances. These antibacterial substances are going to inhibit, means stop, the both gram positive and the gram negative enteric bacteria. And these probiotics are also used to improve the water quality, and it also used to prevent the colonization of the pathogenic bacteria into our body. Colonization means the adhesion, entering the pathogenic bacteria entering into our body, and the multiplication that was prevented or inhibited by these probiotics. Next, coming to the characteristics of the probiotics, what is the main characteristic features must have those must have to the probiotics? Let's see. Those probiotics must be able to survive during the passage through the digestive system. In the digestive system, in the stomach, we have the HCl, right? Any of the compound when entered into the stomach, due to that HCl, it may collapse or destroy. But these probiotics have the ability to passage into that fluid also, through that fluid also. That is a main characteristic feature for these probiotics. Next, it have to attack to the intestinal epithelial cells. Probiotics must have the capability to attack to the intestinal epithelial cells, and it has able to maintain the good viability, means in the living state. It must maintain the good viability, and it is used to utilize the nutrients and substrates in the normal diet. Means if we are taking the food daily, right, in those food the nutrients are also present and the substrates are also present. From the food, the nutrients and substrates are going to utilized by these probiotics. That is a main characteristic feature by this one. And next, each and every probiotic must be a non-pathogenic effect and non-toxic. It do not cause any harm to the host. Next, coming to it has the capability of exerting a beneficial effect on the host. It have to produce a beneficial effects on the host, and it must be safe to the host. Host means the people who are taking taking those probiotics. Those people are known as the host, and the people, and it must have the anti-canceling activity, anti-carcinogenic activity. And it must have the capability to produce the lactic acid in our body, and should retain the viability during the storage and usage. Now we are recently or previously preparing the probiotics as a pill form or as in the powder form. Those pills and powder forms of probiotics are stored and used again. During that period, it must be retained in the viable or the alive state. And next, it must stimulate the immune system of our body. When we take those probiotics into our body, it must have the capability to stimulate, to increase the immune system of our body. And next, coming to the mechanism of action of the probiotics. What is the mechanism of the probiotics when we take the probiotic into our body? This is our human body digestive system. Through the mouth, those probiotics are taking us. This is a passage of the from the mouth, it is entering into the esophagus, and from the esophagus, it is entering into the stomach, and from the stomach to the duodenum and to the large intestine. Finally, it is entering into the small intestine. In the small intestine is lined with the epithelial cells. We all know that, right? This is a small intestine. Here the probiotic is present. This is the complete epithelial cell. Small intestine epithelial cells here. When the probiotics are entered into the epithelial cells, those are getting attached to those epithelial cells. Here, enhancement of the epithelial biome. When the probiotics attaches to the epithelial cells, it is enhancing the epithelial barrier. Next, when the epithelial barrier was enhanced, here it increasing the adhesion to the intestinal mucosa. Adhesion means attachment, means these probiotics are getting attached to the intestinal mucosa is increasing. Next, when the pathogenic, I already said that in our body both good and bad bacteria are present. These are good bacteria or the patho means probiotics, bad bacteria or the pathogenic bacteria. By the attachment of these probiotics, it is going to inhibit the pathogenic bacteria is getting adhered to the epithelial cells of the small intestine. And next role is when the in complete surface of the epithelial cells, probiotics are attached, right? Then the competition was coming between the pathogenic bacteria and the probiotics. Probiotics are not allowing the pathogenic bacteria to get attached to this epithelial cells. This is one of the major mechanism. And next, when the probiotics are attached to those epithelial cells, it is entering into the intestinal, through the intestinal mucosa, it is entering into the cell. From the cell is liberating the interleukins, macrophages, and the immune cells which are fighting against those are getting modified. There the immune system was modified. This was a complete mechanism was happening due to the probiotics. In this way, the immune system of our body is getting improved. And next, coming to the consumed in the form, means in which types, means either food, either as a food form, either as a capsule form, either as a vegetable form, either as a fruit form, in which form we are consuming these probiotics, means in the form of raw vegetables and also as a raw fruits, and also in the fermented pickle forms, and also in the dairy product forms, and also in the pills forms, and also in the powder forms, these probiotics are consumable by us into our body. Next, coming to the what are the foods rich with the probiotics. First, with yogurt. We all know that yogurt is the fermented milk product. It has a rich probiotic content. And next, coming to the kefir. It is also the fermented milk drink. This is made by adding the kefir seeds in it. Next, coming to the sauerkraut. Sauerkraut is a fermented shredded cabbage product. And next, coming to the tempeh. This tempeh is also the fermented soya bean dish. And next, coming to the kimchi. Kimchi is a Korean food, and it is a fermented cabbage product. And next, coming to the miso. Miso is also the fermented soya bean disc. And next, coming to the cambusk. Cambusk is a mainly fermented black or green tea seeds. From those, this product was fermented and prepared. And in the pickles also, the probiotics are very rich. And next, coming to the traditional buttermilk. It is a fermented buttermilk product by the usage of the microorganisms. Next, coming to the natto. Natto is also the one of the fermented milk product, and some of the types of the cheese are also rich with these probiotics. These are the 11 food products which are having the high content of the probiotics in them. Next coming to the advantages of the probiotics. These are used to treat or cure antibiotic associated diarrhea. Means if some of the people takes antibiotics for several other reasons, through these antibiotics they may affect to the diarrhea. For that sake, probiotics are playing a major role to cure or treat them. And in the cancer conditions also, these probiotics are used. And in the hepatitis patients, and in the Helicobacter pylori infection cases, and to treat the high cholesterol content, and for the dental problems, urinary tract infections, and also for the vaginal infections, and also for the dermal infections, means skin infections, these probiotics are playing a major role. These are the advantages of the probiotics. Next, coming to the disadvantages of the probiotics. If we use or taken these probiotics in the high amount, in the large amount, then it may cause digestive issues, means gas problems or the bloating problems. Bloating problems means the stomach may bulge out. That was known as the bloating problem. And also the discomfort in the gastrointestinal tract may affect, and allergies may also cause. These are the disadvantages of the probiotics. This is the complete detailed information about the probiotics. I think you like this class. Thanks for watching.